While they live in harmony and strive for perfection, you can see the different groups of these snailish herd animals assembling and creating change.
Hi there, welcome to Stellaris Ancient Relics again in Nautilon's Second Realm. And the Nautilids are waiting to expand more because they need alloys. We need alloys, and we'll get more alloys, and we'll also send out another scientist. Let's pick one. I don't know who's going to come up with this. Oh, look at that. Umberto Ravelli, the maniac. We could use a maniac here. Bruno Olivieri, the rocket scientist. And Rikuto Yamamoto, the field manipulator. I think we're going to go with Umberto Ravelli to keep us in the row for more rare technologies once he decides to go for. And I think we'll rename this one. He was just called because he has a very magnificent shell. He'll just be called Sheldon. Here we go. And where will he go to explore? Well, we think, I mean, this ship might come back and go for this place. This ship has went this route, and there is this formation here that is still open. So we'll send Sheldon around here. Let's explore and survey this. You maniac. You maniac. Here we go. Oh, look at that. We'll need more energy credits. Leaders are so costly sometimes, right? So, so costly. But it's all worth it. We've got enough food now. Everything's going nicely. Got enough Oh, we've discovered a new archaeological site. Look at that. The Endless expands. At first sight, there's only snow and ice on Canis Nine. Vast expanses of impenetrable white, glass lakes and jagged turquoise glaciers against fiery orange skies, torn open like a wound, pouring red into the seas as Canis stars set. If the world had an end, this would be it. Here the seas lie still and the snow untouched. The only sounds are the thunder of the ice carving and the wind howling across the plains. Oh. Yet Canis Nine was once someone's home. In the midst of a wide barren field, the black metal framework of a steeple protrudes from the white masses. What forgotten secrets could be buried beneath the snow? And can we're at the site, can we go for an excavation? No, because it's outside of our empire. We have to expand more. We have to expand more. We're expanding into that direction. We need another ship. It's clear. We need another ship. Construction complete. But what we also need is we need a better fleet. We need 10 ships at least. Is as it is. And now let's see what we can have here. Now the question is always what to optimize for, and we'll optimize for time as we have enough minerals coming. So we'll go and optimize for timely acquisition of these. Because we've got tons of minerals and we should do it quickly. What would be more plans now? I mean, we're nearing a new tradition. That will be cool. And we could look into settling in the other spots here, but just like that, we only have one. We could upgrade this, but we've got a shipyard and a trade hub. Hmm. always that, always that. I mean, the shipyard should never stand still, ideally. So, we wanted more fleet. Let's get more fleet. Starbase instead of Tony. Yeah, we had that. Kahina system is fully surveyed. And now, where to go? Where to go, Morales? I think this looks like a nice thing to explore. Also, the black hole through which we came and so naively settled here in the Second Realm. We may need more energy credits. Yes, yes, yes. Evasive maneuvers. Aliens. We have encountered some form of alien vessels in the Eye of Baal system. That's why we fled there. There is something come behind us. A menace. What is that? That a test of Nautilon? That from the barbarians we fled from? Should proceed with caution. Contact report. Enigmatic spacefarers. Nautilon's favor is in an uproar following the news of unidentified ships sighted in the void. Their intentions unknown. Be prudent to assume the worst. It's worrying. It's very worrying. Oh my goodness. That. What is that? Planets in a black hole system? That's crazy. Maybe this is a black sun.
Construction complete.
So, here we go. Made it out of this. Thanks, Antonella. Let's see if this is also as dangerous as the other thing was. And continue to look for something. Look at the shipyard. I think we're gonna go for another constructor. But only after the fleet is complete.
System survey complete.
Nice. A tundra world here. 25, my goodness, what a big tundra world. We're gonna look into that. We really need to expand that way. My goodness, we need more. There's a faction founded. Two factions even. A new faction has recently begun gaining traction in the internal political landscape of the Seekers of Nautilon. Led by Uberslayer Naughty III, they call themselves the Closed Borders Network. The members are advocating for closed borders and non-interference with galactic affairs, as we are rulers. Yeah, we've got closed borders. Disgruntled faction will be a source of trouble, but one that approves of the government's actions could prove useful. And we've got the Peaceful Advancement Association. They want solid liquidity. Oh, they want 5,000 stored at all times. Extended peace. 25 years or more will please the Closed Borders Network. We've got a full support here and kind of a little bit of support here.
Everything is nice. Very good, very good. We should look into that. We should look into more fleets first, and then we'll see, we'll see. But we need to expand to Grokon as well. And in this place, oh my goodness, because we get volatile modes there, that will bring our power up to par with a, I don't know, the barbarians maybe, explosive modes? We have never heard of that before.
Construction complete.
Yeah, we're patrolling at the moment.
Anomaly found.
Another anomaly, let's see. In the Brustam system. The three suns. The Brustam A has detected faint traces of weapon radiation indicative of a military spacecraft originating from Brustam A. Maybe we can find it. Let's research, Antonella. You're on it. A trace of Nautilon for sure. Let's see what we can do here. Yeah, we've missed that a bit. Let's see what we need. I mean, it's easy, right? We need a generator district, so let's build one. Mektpuk's civilization. What? Is that a tundra? That's an Arctic world here. We've detected the presence of a pre-space civilization on Vokon. Four in the Vokon system. They are in an early industrial age, with electricity and internal combustion engines gradually coming into widespread use. We should consider building an observation post above their world to study them more closely. It's interesting, it's very interesting. But it's also worrying. I mean, not so much, because they are in the industrial age, so spacefaring is far away. We won't have a conflict. We don't need to do much about them. And we don't need to have contact. Direct contact. And that is good. That is really good. An odd factor. Group of investigators have found a hidden factory on We Shall Overcome Prime? What? The building and its state of decay tells of an old civilization, one that excelled at constructing things that stood the test of time. Our population would easily be able to use the facility to add the colony's production output. Intriguing. An odd factory. What is there here? Well-crafted facility that produces high-value resources left on the planet by a different civilization. Yeah, we'll look into that, but we're a little bit skeptical. Really a little bit skeptical. Another faction was founded by Antonella Morales. They call themselves the Council of Pious Traditionalists. Their members support spiritualist and conservative values. As it should be. Will please them. Empty shells, allowing for the replacement of organic life with robotic workers, will displease the Council of Pious Traditionalists. Oh. We have to look into that. Psionic Pursuit. Adopting the Mind Over Matter Ascension perk will please the Council of Pious Traditionalists and Homogeneity. Pious minds think alike, and having at least 25% of our population be some form of spiritualist will please the Council of Pious Traditionalists. Let's see about that. And oh, there's an alien spacecraft. A badly damaged military vessel bearing elaborate alien insignia circles Brustam A. The ship has suffered a heavy incendiary attack, which has melted its hull, leaving no survivors aboard. No weapons known to us today can produce temperatures high enough to cause such an effect. Perhaps the ship's logs may shed some light on its violent end. We must find out to protect us from these violent weapons. Examine the logs. The logs. Beta menace must also be investigated. Alien logs. Research. Where are the alien logs? Here indeed. Brustum. So research that instantly. Yeah. The energy credits. At least we're going for a generator district here. We shall overcome this crisis. Oh, that's really a crisis. Come on. That's really crazy. Let's see. But we have good growth. Armstrong is here. We got to look more into this place. The odds and ends of the galaxy are so much more likely to not meet any aliens there. Special product complete. The Rubricator. An analysis of the ship's logs reveals that the crew met its demise when trying to retrieve an irreplicable alien artifact called the Rubricator. It was stolen from their society by a pack of thieving rats, a curious choice of words, as they themselves are most rat-like in appearance. Logs are mainly comprised of curses, willing the rat robbers to the end of the universe and beyond. The crew has counted upwards of 50 individual words for defecation, as well as a wide selection of places from which a star's light cannot escape, but their arduous work has paid off. We have uncovered the last known location of the Rubricator in a previously uncharted system, and if we are to believe its former owners, its powers are worth pursuing. We must have the Rubricator, it's a gift of Nautilon. Here we go. Where is it? The Rubricator. Out there in space, everything is possible. Anything is possible. Yeah, we were in Brustum here. Okay. Let's survey that thing then. Then go over here.
Construction complete.
And now we got a fleet of 10, that's not bad. Let's see if we can go for one more construction ship. Let's see if that makes sense. I think it makes sense, so we'll try it. We will try it. Oh my goodness, look at that. No one's going here, but a lot of people are going there. Being newly colonized, yeah, we're losing a bit. The newly colonized planets, but it's the future. We're looking for the future here. And we're going to have a great future. An odd factor. No reports of any problems issued from the odd factory on which we shall overcome Prime. It seems like the colony will maintain the projected production estimates. Nice.
Construction complete.
And now, let's hurry to the media system. We need generators. Oh, good people, we need generators and we need consumer goods. There's so much to be done. I cannot believe how much it is. Some things just have to be.
Anomaly found.
Another anomaly, and in Grokken? What can we do here? That thing. And then this one. Life signs have been detected coming from inside the atmosphere of the gas giant. Could it indicate the presence of some kind of biosphere? Let's research. Okay, we're too curious. That is just too curious. So, and with that said, let's continue. Look there. Let's build that thing already. Oh, we must overcome. And we have enough unity for another tradition, and what will we go for? Adaptability. To adapt is to survive and surpass. That is just what we want to do. Pop housing usage goes down. Adopting all adaptability traditions will unlock the planetary prospecting decision. Allows us to prospect for an additional resource deposit once on our planets. In addition, we'll unlock one ascension perk slot. Very nice. And we want to, of course, go for environmental diversification. Habitability increased by 10%. By adapting to different environments, we have learned to evolve and adapt faster. That's got to be the way. Adapt faster. All is good here. Thank you for watching and happy gaming to you. We'll see each other in the next episode in this giant galaxy. Have a great time until then. And happy gaming. This is Immanuel Kahn, signing out. May Nautilon be with you.